Assalamu alaikum. Today we will calculate arithmetic mean of group data and ungroup data. But before to calculate arithmetic mean, let me tell you very briefly about group data and ungroup data. Ungroup data, what is ungroup data? A non-summarized and non-organized individual data without frequency distribution is called ungroup data. Non-summarized and non-organized individual data. So this is the example. For example, number of children in six different families. X assume number of children. First family has two children. Second family has four children. Third family has six children, and so on and so forth. So these are number of children of different families. These are individual numbers. Okay, each one is individually recorded. Or ungroup without frequency. There is no frequency given. These are individual number, non-organized and non-summarized, and without frequency. These are without frequency. So these number is called ungroup data. This is the formation of ungroup data. Now group data. What is group data? Summarized. There is non-summarized. There is summarized. There is no organized data. There is organized. So the summarized and organized data sorted into different classes with frequency distribution is called group data. Here is with frequency distribution, and ungrouped data is without frequency distribution. So keep in mind, group data will always have frequencies. Okay, group data we can divide into two categories: discrete group data and continuous group data. This is the example of ungrouped data. X assume number of children 2, 4, 6, 8, 4, 6, 4. These are ungrouped because this is without frequency. Now convert this into group data. So group data is two type: discrete group data and continuous group data. Discrete group data, note and keep in mind that discrete group data have always jumping points. Jumping points mean 1, 2, 3, 4, or you can say 2, 4, 6. These are, each number has some jumping between the two. So this is called jumping point. So discrete grouping frequency distribution. So start from the lowest number, which is 2, and cover up to the highest number, which is 6. 2, 4, 6. 2 is repeat here one time, 4 repeat here three times, 6 repeat here two times. This become discrete grouping frequency distribution. This is a form of grouping frequency. Now continuous grouping. Continuous grouping, well, continuous grouping. For continuous group, keep in mind, continuous data have always interval like A to B. Continuous data will always have interval. Like A to B mean from maybe from 0 to 5, 5 to 10, or 0 to 10, 10 to 20, like this one. So this is the A to B, like this one. So from 2 to 4, then 5 to 7. 2 is the smallest number in the example, and cover the highest number, which is 6. So the last class cover the highest number. So from 2 to 4, how many number are there from 2 to 4? 1, 2, 3, 4. So right from 2 to 4 there are 4 children, 4 families, and from 5 to 7 there is only 2 families, 6 and 6. This is between 5 to 7, there are only these 2 families. Now first we will calculate arithmetic mean for ungrouped data. This question is ungrouped data. Age of 10 selected professors of a certain college are given below. These are the ages of different professors. This is ungrouped data. Why ungrouped data? Each number is individually recorded, or these are without frequency. So this is ungrouped data. Calculate arithmetic mean by direct method and indirect method. So first of all, arithmetic mean by direct method. So this is a basic formula for calculation of arithmetic mean by direct method. Arithmetic mean is equal to sum of values divided by number of values. This is the basic idea of arithmetic mean. Sum of values divided by number of value. Sum of values, we can write mathematically summation x. n number of values, mathematically n is the number of values. So sum of values, so add up all these number. So 50 plus 55 plus 46 and the last number is 52, divided by how many number are these? These are 10 number divided by 10. So when you add up a divide by 10, you will get 43 as arithmetic mean for direct method. Now we have to find arithmetic mean by indirect method. Arithmetic mean by indirect method, the formula for indirect method is x bar is equal to capital A plus summation d over n. So first of all we have to find d. D is the difference. So d mean x minus a. A is assumed mean that we always consider from x values. So you can assume any value from the x. Let's suppose 35 is our a assumed mean. Always consider a from x values. Okay, so 35 is our assumed value and this is a. Now x minus 35 mean x minus a, this become difference d. So x is this number. So 50 minus 35 you will get 15, 55 minus 35 we will get 20, 46 minus 35 we will get 11, 40 minus 35 we will get 5, 35 minus 35 0, 38 minus 35 3, 42 minus 35 7, 24 minus 35 is minus 11, 48 minus 35 is 13, 52 minus 35 is 17. Now here in the formula it is summation d. Sum of d mean, summation d means sum of d. So these are the d numbers. So add up now these d number. After add up we will get 80. 80 is the total of these deviation, or the d answer is, summation d answer is 80. Now replace or substitute the numbers here. A is assumed value, which is 35. So for a write 35, for summation d write 80, and n total number these number are 10. So first of all 80 divided by 10 we will get 8. 80 divided by 10 will give us 8. 8 plus 35 is 43. 43 is our arithmetic mean by indirect method. So by direct method and indirect method we will get the same answer. The direct method answer is 43 and the indirect answer is also 43. Now the next question. A variable take values. These are the different values of a variable. Calculate arithmetic mean by using direct method and indirect method. So these are x values. This is ungrouped data. Why ungrouped data? There is no frequency in this question. Each number is repeat individually. These are ungrouped data. So first of all I can write this number in table. X assume these values. I can assume this number by x. So x is 5, 10, 15, 5, 7, these number. Okay. Now the direct formula, arithmetic mean by direct method is equal to arithmetic mean, sum of values divided by number of values. Sum of values is summation x mathematically n number of values. So sum of values means sum of these x. So what is the total of x is 140. 140 is the sum of x. So write here 140 and n total number. These total number are 10. So divide by 10. 140 divided by 10 we will get 14. 14 is our arithmetic mean answer by using direct method. Now find arithmetic mean of these ungrouped data by indirect method, or we can say shortcut method. So the formula for finding arithmetic mean by shortcut method is arithmetic mean equal to a plus summation d over n. A is assumed value. Okay, a is assumed value and assumed value from x. A, now here I assume a from x, which is 7. So a is equal to 7 is assumed value from x. Now summation d, sum of d. So before to find the sum of d, first we have to find d, the difference. How to find difference? D is equal to x minus a. A is 7. We can assume any value from this x. this is a. So x minus a or x minus 7. So 5 minus 7 is minus 2. 10 minus 7 is 3. 15 minus 7, 8. 5 minus 7, minus 2. 7 minus 7 is 0. Now 3 minus 7 is minus 4. 20 minus 7, 13. 40 minus 7, 33. 0 minus 7 is minus 7. 35 minus 7, 28. Now these are the deviation, or we can say these number are D. Now find sum of D, sum of these number, which is 70. Now replace these number and this formula. A assume value, A is assume value, which is 7. So write for A 7. Summation D, sum of D, the sum of D is 70. So for sum of D, summation D is 70 and n number of values is 10. 70 divide 10 is 7. 7 plus 7 is 14. So both formula will give us same answer. Direct method and indirect method both will give same answer, which is 14 and 14. And this question, now we will discuss all three methods. Direct method, assume value 70 is called indirect method and coding method. So in this question we will discuss all three method: direct method, indirect method and coding method. So first one, direct method. The question is calculate arithmetic mean by direct method using assume mean as 70. Using assume mean as 70 mean, this is A and this is the indication of indirect method. Now taking u is equal to x minus 40 over 10. When u is given, u mean this is coding method. U is equal to x minus a over h. This is a below is h. For the variable x, which take the values. So these are the values of a variable x. So this is also ungrouped data. Why ungrouped data? Each number is repeat individually and without frequency. These are ungrouped data. Also compare the results of all three methods. So solution, indirect method. So this is the number of x. So I can write this number in this table. Column form, x assume this value. X is 100, 90, 50, this number. Now for direct method, the formula is x bar is equal to summation x over n. Summation x means total of x. So total of this x column, which is 550. So 550 divided by n, total number. How many number are this? 10 divided by 10. So 550 divided by 10, we will get x bar is equal to 55. Now indirect method. Indirect method formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation d over n. D is the difference or deviation. D is equal to x minus a. A is assume value that we will consider always from a. But here it is given in the question, A is given in the question, which is 70. Assume mean A 70, it is given. So we cannot assume it in advance. So A is 70, so we can say A is 70 here from this X number. Now find D. How to find this D? X minus 70. So 100 minus 70, 30. 90 minus 70, 20. 50 minus 70, minus 20. 60 minus 70, minus 10. 40 minus 70, minus 30, and so on and so forth. We will get these numbers. These are the, this is the D column. Now add up this D. This, when we add up this D, this becomes sum of D. Now replace this number here. X bar is equal to A plus summation D over A over N. A assume value, which is 70. Here A is 70. So A is 70. Summation D total is 550. So 550 divided by n. N is 10. So D is minus 150. So D is minus 150 divided by 10. So when we divide, we will get minus 15. 17 minus 15 is equal to 55. 55. This is the answer of arithmetic mean by indirect method. Now part C, coding method. Coding method, which is also called strip deviation method. The formula for strip deviation or coding method is x bar equal a plus summation u divided by n multiply h. This u is given in the question. Taking u is equal to x minus 40 divided by 10. So how to calculate u? X minus 40 divide 10, it is given in the question. So I did here in the third column. U is equal to x minus 40 over 10. What does this mean? It means that first of all we have to subtract 40 from each value of x, then divide the difference by 10. So these are x. So 100 minus 40, which is 60. 60 divide 10 is 6. Then 90 minus 40, which is 50. 50 divided by 10 is 5. 50 minus 40, which is 10. 10 divided by 10 is 1. Then 60 minus 40, which is 20. 20 divided by 10 is 2. Now 40 minus 40 is 0. 0 divided by 10 is 0. 30 minus 40 is minus 10. Minus 10 divided by 10 is minus 1. 20 divided minus 40 divided by 10 is minus 2. 70 minus 40 divided by 10 is 3. 10 minus 40 divided by 10 is 3. 80 minus 40 divided by 10 is 4. So now these are the value of u. Now add up all these, we will get 15. 15 is the sum of u. Now replace this value in this formula. Coding method formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation u over n multiply h. What is u? U is this one. U is equal to x minus a divide h. So compare this number. Here is in the question u is equal to x minus 40 over 10. It is given in the question here. U minus 40 over 10. Now compare these two. So a is 40. Now divide by h. Minus number is a, so it is 40. Divide by number is h, so h is 10. So a is 40 and h is 10. Replace this number in this formula. A is 40 and summation u is 15, and total number which is 10, h is the divide number which is 10. Now after divide and multiply we will get the answer. A is 40, summation u is 15, divided by 10, multiply 10 is h. Now this 10 cancel, we will get 15 plus 40 is equal to 55. 55 is the answer. Now compare three answer. All three, direct method, indirect method and coding method, will have same answer. By comparing the results of all three method, we will always same. The answer of all three method is same, which is 55. Here x bar is equal to 55 is same for all three. This is the answer for coding method.